Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. This is Sharon Oyala and this is part 3 of our Dress Me Up Bunny. In this video we're making overalls for the bunny that we crocheted in the last two videos. If you missed the first two parts, those will be linked in the pinned comment below. You'll find pattern links in the pinned comment below. However, I do bring the entire pattern to you on the screen as we work through the overalls together. But if you prefer a written pattern, that option again is in the pinned comment below. Of course, when you're making the clothes for the bunny, you want to use the same weight yarn as you did for the bunny. And the hook size, you want to go up just a little bit. So for the bunny, I used a 4mm hook. For the overalls, I'm using a 4.25mm hook. You'll also need a yarn needle for sewing. And 3 buttons. You can use anywhere from a 1/2 inch to 1 inch button. I'll put the millimeters on the screen. And those sizes will work well with the buttonhole loops that we do in this pattern. And to make the overalls, you'll need approximately 100 yards of yarn. Now I guesstimated above what we actually use, but I would say 100 yards is a good amount to have when you start this project. Row 1 is chain 42, and we're going to begin with a starting yarn tail about 12 to 15 inches long. We're going to use this to make a buttonhole loop later. So to begin, we have to start with a slip knot. So I'm going to hold the yarn like this, and I'm going to twist the top, and then reach down and grab the working yarn and pull it through the loop. And that's our slip knot. Let's try it again. Twist, reach down, grab the yarn, and pull it through the loop. And there we go, we can get that onto our hook. And you'll see my starting yarn tail is about 15 inches long. All right, so let's chain 42. And a little reminder, just grab that yarn and pull it through the loop on your hook. And you do that 42 times. You can go ahead and pause the video now, and we'll meet back here at the end of the chain. Welcome back. Here's my chain of 42. Let's take a look at the pattern. Row 2, starting in the second chain from the hook, 1 single crochet in each chain. At the end, we're going to chain 2 and turn. So looking for the second chain from the hook, here's the first one. We're going into the second one. Push your hook through. When you go through the chain, make sure you have 2 loops of that chain on top of your hook and 1 on the bottom. Now we can do our single crochet, pull the yarn through, and pull the yarn through the 2 loops on your hook. And there was 1 single crochet in the second chain from the hook. And you can see we've just worked that one because that loop's a little bit bigger going into the next chain. And everything's a little bit awkward to hang on to as you're working a chain, so just take your time. You can see we've already worked that one. It's got a bigger loop getting into the next chain. All right, guys, I'm going to let you pause the video now, and we'll meet back here 3 chains before the end. All right, guys, welcome back. I have 3 chains left. Just work this one here. 1, 2, 3. So when I was first learning how to crochet, these chains always kind of messed me up a little bit because they looked a little bit wonky and it was just had to do with my tension. So I would have found it helpful if somebody just walked me through the very end of the chain. Mine look a little bit neat and tidy here, but I know when you're first learning, sometimes they can look a little bit wonky. So getting into that last chain. There we go. And because we started in the second chain from the hook, we now have 41 stitches. So you can pull that big loop. The first one is underneath that big loop. 1, 2, 3, and you keep going all the way to the end, counting those V's. And at the very end, this is what it should look like. There's the last one of the row. That was 41. Now let's take a look at the pattern. For rows 3 to 6, we're going to skip that chain at the start of each row. We're going to chain 2 and turn at the end of each row. At the end of row 7, do not chain 2 and turn. So rows 3 to 7 is 1/2 double crochet in each stitch for 5 rows. So chain 2, 1, 2, and turn. Now turn the chain towards you so that you can see the V's. We're going to start in the 3rd V from the hook. So that's skipping that chain 2, 1, 2, and we're starting into the 3rd V right there. So a 1/2 double crochet is the same as a single. You just yarn over before going into the stitch. So yarn over, go through that stitch, grab the yarn and pull it through. You have 3 loops on your hook. Grab the yarn and pull it through all 3 loops. And that was a 1/2 double crochet. Now yarning over into the next stitch. And remember to turn it towards you to look for the V's if you get confused. And make sure every time you go through a stitch that you have 2 loops of that stitch on top of your hook. So you're not just picking up 1 loop of the stitch. Grab the yarn and pull it through. Now you have 3 loops. Grab the yarn and pull through all 3 loops. Let's do another one. Yarn over. Go through, grab the yarn, and pull it through. Grab the yarn and pull through all 3 loops. All right, my friends, I'm going to let you pause the video now and work your way across. We're going to meet back here 3 stitches before the end of the row. Welcome back. I've made my way across and I have 3 stitches left to go. So let's do this end of the row together. So I'm turning it towards you. You can see 3 V's there. 1, 2, 3. Let's put a half double crochet in each one of those. Yarning over and going through. Now we have 2 stitches left. And 1 left to go. Now the end of this one will seem a little bit wonky, but make sure when you go through you have 2 loops of that stitch on your hook. So you're not just picking up 1 loop of the stitch. And that's the end of the row. And that completes row 3. So remember, every time you finish a row, put a little notch on your pattern so you can keep track. And when you have 5 of those, you know you're done that section of the pattern. So chain 2, 1, 2, and turn. And starting in the 3rd V from the hook, so skipping that chain, working the first stitch of the row, yarn over, and when you go through, making sure that you have both loops of the stitch on your hook. All right, guys, I'm going to skip ahead to the end so you can see what the end looks like before we put in that last half double crochet. I've made it across and I have 1 stitch left in the row. So the end of the rows are always going to look a little bit funny. So just make sure you're working that last stitch. And that was the end of row 4 for me. So I'm going to put a little notch beside my pattern. Once you have 5 completed rows, we'll meet back here. Go ahead and pause the video now. All right, my friends, welcome back. We're at the end of row 7, and this is where we're going to do our buttonhole. So pull out your last stitch and leave it hanging so you don't lose it. And the starting yarn tail, we're going to push our hook right through the base of where it's coming out of. So pushing through and grab that yarn tail, pull it through. Now chain 4, 1, 2, 3, and 4. And we're going to single crochet into the side here, the length of the chain. So I just had to pop in with an edit because that first clip didn't turn out the way I wanted it to. And you can see it's a little bit of a struggle there because it's tight, but you can get your hook in there. Do your single crochet, and now we're going to pull the yarn tail through that loop and pull it tight. And then thread that yarn tail with your yarn needle. There's our buttonhole loop. But what I want to do is knot it off right here. So I'm going to bring it through, and I'm going to knot this off before I weave in the yarn tail, just to make this buttonhole loop nice and solid. So go through that loop there before pulling it all the way through, and then pull that nice and tight, and make sure that it's knotted. You might have to add another one, and now we can weave in the yarn tail. All right, so I'm going to bring it through right here, and I'm going through the center of the stitches, so you can't see my yarn needle on the other side. See, like that? So right in the center of the stitches, pull it through, and now just go up a little ways, and then back down in the opposite direction. Moving on to row 8, we're going to hold the ends of row 7 together. We're going to connect those ends with 1 half double crochet, and then we're going to do a half double crochet in the remaining stitches. So get ready to crochet on. We're going to pick up the other end of row 7, and we're going to hold the ends together, and we'll put a half double crochet in that first stitch of the row, this one right here. So hold them together, yarn over, go through that stitch, grab the yarn and pull it through. And now pull through all 3 to complete your half double crochet. And there was the first stitch of the row, so we can add a marker into that last stitch of the row. And I can't find my marker, so I'm just going to put in a piece of yarn of a different color. And now we're going to continue on with 1 half double crochet in the remaining 40 stitches. So I'll let you pause the video now, and we'll meet back here once we land on the marker. Welcome back. I just got to the end of row 8. I'm just going to show you what it looks like. So the first stitch of the row is that connecting half double crochet. So let's add a marker into our last stitch we just put in, and we'll take a look at the pattern. Row 9 is 1 half double crochet in each one of those 41 stitches for 1 row. So the first one goes into that connecting one. So you just work it like normal, just going through. And there's 1 half double crochet. Now put a half double crochet in each of the remaining stitches. You can go ahead and pause the video. We'll meet back here at the end of the row. Welcome back. I just got to the end of the row. I'm going to put in my last half double crochet. I'll move my marker and let's take a look at the pattern. Row 10 is where we separate the pant leg. So we're going to put a half double crochet in the next 2 stitches, chain 3, and slip stitch into the 20th stitch from the front of the chain. And then we're going to turn. All right, so 1 half double crochet in the next 2 stitches. And that brings us up to the center where the pants are separated in the back there. And now we're going to chain 3. 1, 2, 3. And then from the front of the chain, starting right here, we're going to count to the 20th stitch. the front of the chain right here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Count all the way up to 20. And there's my 20th stitch right there. So I'm going to slip stitch that one. So pull the yarn through both loops. And now turn and chain one. And that chain one counts as a stitch. We finished the first part of row 10. You can pause to read. We're going to do the next part of row 10. Now we're going to put one half double crochet in the next three stitches and then two half double crochets into the fourth. And we're going to repeat that sequence, one in the next three, two into the fourth. We're going to do that sequence 5 times in total. You can go ahead and pause the video now, guys, and we'll meet back here at the end of the row. Welcome back. I just finished row 10. I'm moving my marker. We're going to take a look at the pattern. You can pause to read. We're going to be doing row 11. Let's do this first part together here. So in front of the marker, there's going to be one stitch. And we're going to work that with a half double crochet. And then we're going to work half double crochets in the next three back loops of the chain. And then we're going to put a half double crochet into that chain one that we did in the beginning. So one half double crochet in the first stitch, and that's going through both loops of that stitch. And now we're going to be working in the back loops of the chain. So one half double crochet in the next three back loops. And there's my third one there. And now we're going to put a half double crochet into that chain one that we did at the beginning. So it's a little bit tight. You got to push your hook through. Take your time. Make sure you're going through both loops of this of the chain. Pull the yarn through. And again, it's very tight there. And there we go. We made it through. Let's take a look what that looks like. And now we just have to put a half double crochet in the remaining stitches to the marker. So you can go ahead and pause the video now, guys, and we'll meet back here once we finish this row. Welcome back. I just finished row 11 and we should have 30 stitches around. Let's take a look at the pattern. Rows 12 to 13 is one half double crochet in each one of those 30 stitches for two rows. So you can go ahead and pause the video now and meet me back here at the end of row 13. Welcome back. I'm at the end of row 13 and this is what it should look like now. We're almost there, guys. One more row to go. Row 14, one half double crochet in each of the front loops only for one row. So again, we're working in the front loops only. And remember, that's the one closest to you. So half double crochet in each one of those 30 front loops. You can go ahead and pause the video now, guys, and we'll meet back here at the end of the row. All right, I'm at the end of row 14. Now we're going to slip stitch the next stitch and finish off. And when you cut free, just leave a little bit of a yarn tail because we're going to weave it in when we're done. So you just roll up the pant legs, thread your yarn needle. I'm going to bring this underneath and back around to the front. And that will just pull that little knot up so it doesn't look like a jump in the bottom of the pants there. Now I'll bring this to the other side and I'll knot it off on the inside. Don't pull too tight, it will alter the shape of the leg there. So I'll just knot it off right here. And then I'll just weave this in. Cut it free. Now moving on to the second pant leg, you can pause to read. We'll do this part together. With the front of the pants facing you, take a look at the top here. And you can see 20 visible V's starting right here. They go all the way around. You can count them. 1, 2, 3. And the 20th one might be a little bit hidden. You just pull it out there. You'll see the top of the V right there. So there should be 20 of those. And what we're going to do is we're going to add 5 half double crochets right in this area right here. So we're going to borrow a post on this side. And we're going to borrow a post on the other side. And then we're going to use 3 visible loops right here. So pulling the yarn through the first post in the back loop of that post. So going through that back loop. So just split the post. Go through and pull the yarn through. And then hang on to that starting yarn tail so it doesn't pull through. And we're going to do a chain one just to hold the yarn in place. So this does not count as a stitch. So chain one. Now we can let go of that starting yarn tail. And now we're going to do a half double crochet through the whole post. So right through. And that's our first stitch of the row. All right, now we're going to put a half double crochet in the next 3 visible loops. And what we can do is we can work over this starting yarn tail and bury it as we go. If it's too awkward to hang on to, don't worry about it. You can let it go and just weave it in at the end. So over the next 3 loops, half double crochet and hold that yarn tail over the hook and complete the stitch. Next loop, hold that yarn tail over and complete the stitch. And last loop. Now we can let go of that starting yarn tail and we'll cut that free after we're done. All right, so now we're going to put a half double crochet in that post. Half double crochet. And if you take a look here, you should have 5 stitches now in that area. So finishing up the row, we're going to repeat the sequence. 1 half double crochet in the first 3 stitches, and then 2 half double crochets into the fourth, and then repeat that. We're going to do that sequence 5 times. You can go ahead and pause the video now. I'm going to meet you back here when we have 4 stitches left, and we'll complete the row together. I'm at the end of the row. I'm going to put 1 half double crochet in the next 3, and then 2 into the fourth stitch. I'll speed it up. And that brings us to the end of the first row. And taking a look at the pattern, you can pause to read. Rows 2 to 3 is 1 half double crochet in each one of those stitches for 2 rows. Row 4 is 1 half double crochet in the front loops only for 1 row. And then a slip stitch into the next stitch and finish off just like we did for the first leg and weave in the yarn tail. But let's do the first part of row 2 together. Now let's start this row together because it looks a little wonky here. So remember that first V there is a chain. We're going to skip that. We're going to get into the first stitch of the row. We don't hit that one there. Go into that one. So that's the first stitch of the row. So 1 half double crochet into there. And there we go. We are on our way. So I'm going to let you pause the video now. You can finish up this leg on your own. And we'll meet back here once you weaved in that final yarn tail. Now, sometimes when you're finished, there might be a little bit of a gap in the very front. And that's because we borrowed one of the posts and it kind of pulled it. If it's noticeable and you want to close it up, just use the finishing yarn tail to do that. So I've already weaved it down a ways here, and I'm going to go right up in front of the gap. So I'll weave it back over to the front of the gap, and I'm going to sew over it. So just like that. So bring in my yarn needle through, and then right there. And then I'll sew that together, pull it, and it'll close up that gap. There we go. Now it's unnoticeable. So now all we have to do is just knot this off and then weave in this yarn tail. So I'll knot it right here and I'll weave this down. Remember, I'm going in the center of the stitches, so you can't see the yarn needle on the inside there. It's going through, and then I'm going to weave it down even further. That way I don't have to worry about a bit of a tail ever coming through. All right, now I can cut it free. Moving on to the front panel, you can pause to read. You're going to take yourself to the end of row 8. We'll meet back here at the end of row 8. All right, welcome back. I'm at the end of row 8. We're going to chain 4 and turn. And now skipping that chain, we're going to slip stitch the fourth stitch. So skip the chain, count the stitches. There's the fourth one right there. So slip stitch there. Pull the first loop through the second loop, and now slip stitch the next 4 stitches. Now chain 4, and slip stitch into the last stitch of the row. Remember, that last stitch is always a little bit wonky, so make sure you're going through both loops of that stitch. Pull the yarn through, and that's our final slip stitch. Now we can cut free. Make sure to have about an 18 inch long yarn tail. We're going to use that for sewing. And this shorter yarn tail, we're just going to weave into the bottom stitches here. We don't have to knot this one off because it's going to be sewn in place anyway. And the longer yarn tail, we're going to weave it down about an inch from the top, right about there. And we'll set this aside until we're ready to sew it in place. So moving on to the straps now, you can pause to read. When you're ready to sew on the buttons, come back here and we'll do that part together. All right, welcome back. We're going to sew on the buttons. And first of all, we're going to weave in one of the yarn tails. So we'll just bring it up a little ways and we'll cut it free. We don't have to knot this one off either because it's going to be sewn in place. And the other yarn tail, you want to make sure that you have a 12 to 15 inch yarn tail. This one's a little bit too short, so you want one a little bit longer. And of course, you can always add in yarn if you need to. So let's thread our button first. I'm going to bring it through and then go right down another buttonhole. And before pulling it all the way, I'm going to loop it So it hangs onto that button and I don't have to worry about the thread knot being pulled through the yarn. So pull that through and then pull that tight. So that's stuck to the button now. We can just thread this through the end of the strap and the end of the strap without the yarn tails. Now we can sew this in place. Make sure you weave it back and forth a number of times so it's nice and sturdy. When you're done, you can knot off in the back. And then I just bring it through one more time and then I'll cut free. And we'll set those aside until we're ready to sew them in place. While we're adding buttons, don't forget to add one to the back of the pants as well. Moving on to the back pockets, you can pause to read. We'll meet back here at the end of row 6. So we're just going to weave in the shorter yarn tail, and again, we don't have to knot this one off. It's going to be sewn in place. And there we go. Let's start sewing everything together. So we'll put the pockets on first. Now I put mine on the side. That way I can tuck the bunny's arms in the pockets if I want to, but you can put them wherever you want. So on the side, and the top of the pocket's going to be sewn right to that row there. So just eyeing it up to make sure I have it even on both sides. So when we're sewing the pockets in place, we don't want to be whip stitching. We want to sew along the edge, like vertically along the edge, piercing those stitches. Otherwise you'll get holes in your pockets when the yarn pulls it tight. So just along the edge, just like this, and around all three sides, of course. So I'm coming to the end here. I just skipped ahead. Of course, you don't sew the top in. Once you're done, you just knot it off in the back and then weave in the yarn tail. And the front panel, remember we weaved the yarn tail down to about an inch from the top. Now you can place the pants on the bunny and see where you want this front panel to be sitting, like how high you want it to be sitting. This is how high I wanted mine to be. So I'll show you from the back here. And we're going to be sewing along the edges just like we did the pockets. So not whip stitching. You want to be piercing these stitches along the side and along the bottom as well. So we'll do three sides. This is my final one here. And you can leave the top open just like that. It gives you another pocket. And we'll just knot off when we're done and weave that yarn tail in. And for the straps, I put the pants on the bunny and then attach the buttons. And we're going to crisscross these in the back. So attaching the button. I've already got the one strap sewn in place. And of course, they get sewn on either side of the separation. I just want to make sure that it's going to be fully extended. So I'm going to push this end inside all the way. And then I'll undo the buttons. And I'm holding it in place. And now I can sew it. Of course, you can take the pants off the bunny as well. And I'll do a number of stitches to make sure that this is sewn in quite sturdy. You don't want to just add one or two because the yarn will eventually stretch and pull. So you want to make sure this is nice and sturdy. So a number of stitches back and forth the whole length of that strap on the inside. When you're done, just knot off and weave in the yarn tail. Moving on to the shoes, you can pause to read. I'm going to let you do the first 10 rows on your own. If you need help, look at the first 5 rows. They're the exact same as the bunny head. So if you need help, go back to that video and you'll get through the first 5 rows. And then 6 to 9 is one single crochet in each one of those 30 stitches for 4 rows. Row 10 is a decreasing row, one single crochet in the next 3 stitches, and then 2 together. We'll meet back here at the end of row 10. Welcome back. We're at the end of row 10 and we now have 24 stitches around. Row 11, one single crochet in the first stitch, one half double crochet in the next 12 stitches, one single crochet in the next stitch, then chain 9 and slip stitch into the 12th stitch from the start of the chain. Let's do this together. We're going to start the row with one single crochet in the first stitch and now one half double crochet in the next 12 stitches. And I'll jump ahead to the end. All right, I just finished my 12th one, so now one single crochet in the next stitch and chain 9. And now I'm going to slip stitch into the 12th stitch from the front of the chain. Make sure that the working yarn is in front of the hook. Just make it easier for that slip stitch. Then you can hang on to the chain at the same time. Now we'll break free and pull tight, and we're going to weave in the yarn tail. So I'll just bring it down a little ways, and I'll go this way, in between the stitches, remember. Pull on that slightly and cut, and cute little shoes. Now the part with the half double crochet is the back of the shoe, of course. All right, so let's make him some carrots for his pocket. So these carrots start at the top and they work down to the tip. So when you make your magic circle, you want to leave a little bit of a gap in the center. It should look like this. This is where we're going to be pulling the green yarn through when we're ready to do that part. So I'm going to let you carry on the first three rows on your own. We'll meet back here at the end of row three. All right, welcome back. We are at the end of row three and we should have 12 stitches around. I'm just going to thread my yarn needle here with the green yarn and let's take a look at the pattern. So we're going to pull that green yarn through and we're going to wrap around the ring of row one. So pulling it through the center and now wrapping around that ring all around row one, around and around until it's all filled in like this. And now we're going to cut the yarn to about an inch or so, and then the other end, going to cut that as well and bring that through and cut that one. These two are anchored in place. Any more strands that you put in, you're going to have to anchor. So I'm going to pull this one through and then I'll bring it down to the same height as the other ones. So bring it down, and the other end I'm going to thread that one, turn this inside out, and then knot it here. But be careful with these knots, because sometimes when you go through, if you knot it one time, you can still pull the strand through. So I'm going to show you here. So I've just knotted it, but look at that, I can pull it still. So I'm going to knot it again and that will anchor it. And then I cut them all to the same length and then we'll fray these at the end. Let's take a look at the pattern. You can pause to read. I'm going to let you continue on to the end of row nine. All right, my friends, we're at the end of row nine. Now I'm going to finish off here. I'm going to leave a yarn tail for sewing. Let's bring that through, bring it down a little bit, and then pull tight. Now we're going to thread this, and we're going to weave in and out of the remaining front loops only. So through once, and the other way, weaving in and out of all those remaining front loops. All right, now we're going to stuff it. I'm going to use that chopstick here to get the stuffing in there. Okay, now I can pull on the yarn tail and that closes it up and brings it down to a good point. Now I'm going to squish the stuffing in there and make sure I got it right to the end, and I'll knot off, pull tight, and then bring the yarn tail through anywhere, pull on it slightly, and cut. Now we can fray the ends. If you look at the yarn, it's wrapped in a certain direction, so you can unwrap that and then stick your needle through to fray the ends. And of course that part is optional. I think they look great either way. But that brings us to the end of this video, guys. I hope you enjoyed making your bunny with his overalls and his little carrot in his pocket. If you're interested in making the dress that's available, that link should be popping up on your screen. If it's not, just look in the pinned comment below. You'll find the links there. Thanks so much for watching, and we'll see you in the next one.